हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम सचिन हरिदास रोहने, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, यशोदा टेक्निकल कैंपस, फैकल्टी ऑफ फार्मेसी, सातारा। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन द ड्रग एंड कॉस्मेटिक एक्ट 1940 एंड रूल्स 1945। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द हिस्ट्री, देन द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स रिगार्डिंग डी एंड सी एक्ट एंड सम डेफिनेशन कम्स अंडर डी एंड सी एक्ट। नाउ लेट्स सी द हिस्ट्री ऑफ ड्रग एंड कॉस्मेटिक एक्ट 1940 एंड रूल्स 1945। The origin of DNC Act has a very interesting historical background. The enactment of Act was an outcome of struggle shown by medical and pharmaceutical fraternity in pre-independent era against British misrule in providing poor healthcare system to Indian citizen. The drug bill was introduced as a Drug and Cosmetic Act in 1940, and the rule were framed in 1945. That's why it is called as Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940 and Rules 1945. In this act, there are certain chapters. Chapter 1, that is Introduction. Chapter 2 covers the statutory bodies like DTAB, CDL and DCC. Chapter 3, which provides an idea about the import of drugs and cosmetic. Chapter 4, the some guidance regarding manufacture, sales and distribution of drug and cosmetic. Chapter 4A, again some guidance regarding Ayurveda, Siddha and Yunani. And chapter 5, that is miscellaneous one. Now let's see the objectives related to Drug and Cosmetic Act. Now first objective, to regulate the import, manufacture, distribution and sales of drug and cosmetic through licensing. It means that they provide certain guidelines to regulate the import, manufacture, distribution and sales of drug and cosmetic. Second objective of DNC Act, that is manufacture, distribution and sales of drug and cosmetic should be done by a qualified person, right? So it means that the importance of qualified person is the second objective as per the DNC Act. Third, the objective regarding the quality of drug, right? There should not be any type of compromise regarding quality. So third objective is to prevent a substandard in drug. Fourth, again, there are certain guidelines to regulate the manufacture and sales of Ayurveda, Siddha and Yunani. Just like allopathic drug, they also provide guidelines for Ayurveda, Siddha and Yunani drug. The last objective of this DNC Act is to establish statutory bodies like DTAB and DCC for allopathic and allied drugs and cosmetic too. Right? So these are the objectives in DNC Act. Now let's see certain definition which comes under DNC Act. It is drug, cosmetic, misbranded drug, adulterated drug, spurious drug, and manufacture. Now let's see the definition of drug. Now this is the first definition of drug as per DNC Act. All medicine for internal or external use of human beings or animals, and all substances intended to be used for or in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation, or prevention of any disease or disorder in human beings or animals, including preparation applied on human body for the purpose of repelling insect like a mosquito, right? So any substance which is used either internal or external for the purpose of diagnosis, treatment, or mitigation considered to be as a drug. Now, second definition of drug, such substance other than food, whatever we ingesting other than food, intended to affect the structure of any other in function of the human body or intended to be used for the destruction of wormy or insect which cause disease in the human beings or animal. So whatever we ingesting to kill the bacteria or insect, it also considered as a drug. Now third definition, the substance used as a component of a drug, including empty gelatin capsule. Everyone knows the capsule dosage form, right? The capsule shell contain the drug, right? So here capsule shell also considered to be as a drug. Now the fourth definition of drug as per DNC Act, the device used for internal or external use in the diagnosis, treatment, mitigation or prevention of disease or disorder in human beings or animals. Here we are giving importance to device, either used internally or externally, right? And as may be specified from time to time by the central government by notification in the official gazette after consultation with the DTAB, that device also considered to be as a drug. So these are the four definition of drug as per DNC Act. Now let's see cosmetic. Now let's see how it is differ from drug. Now what it will do? Now what is cosmetic? Any article intended to be rubbed, poured, sprinkled, or sprayed, or introduced into, or otherwise applied to the human body or any part thereof, for what purpose? For cleansing, beautifying, promoting attractiveness, or altering the appearance. And includes any article intended for use as a component of cosmetic. That is called cosmetic. Right? So generally, it is used for attractiveness or to alter the appearance. Right? So this is definitely differ from drug. Right? Now let's see the misbranded drug. Now the drug definition is over, cosmetic definition is over. Now let's see the misbranded drug. So if it is not labeled in prescribed manner, no doubt the guidelines is already given how to prescribe the label, what should be the content of label. If it is not in prescribed manner, it is also considered as a misbranded drug. If it is so colored, coated, powder or polished that damage is sealed or concealed, right? So to cover the damage, if it is colored, coated, it is also called as misbranded drug, or it is made to appear or greater therapeutic value than it is really. So it is polishing in a, such a manner that it having more therapeutic value than original, then again it's called as a misbranded drug. If the label or container or anything accompanying the drug bears any statement, design or device which makes any false claim, right, for the drug, that drug is also considered as a misbranded drug. If the information is misleading, if it is false information, that drug is called as misbranded drug. Now let's see the adulterated drug. If it consists in whole or in part of any filthy, putrid, that is dirty or decomposed substance, that drug considered to be as a adulterated drug. If it has been prepared, packed or stored under insanitary condition, it means unhygienic condition, no doubt, definitely, it will contaminate the prepared material, that is the drug. So considered to be as an adulterated drug, where it may have been contaminated with filth or whereby it may have been rendered injurious to health. No doubt, such a drug is injurious to our health. So such a kind of drug is also considered to be as an adulterated drug. If its container is composed in whole or in part of any poisonous or deleterious substance which may render content injurious to health. It means that we have to use suitable container for suitable drug. If the reaction takes place between drug and container, definitely there may be chances of the toxicity may produce in the drug, and that drug considered to be as a adulterated drug. So we have to choose suitable container. If it bears or contains a color other than prescribed one, it means that we have to use only those color which is prescribed in formula. If we are using different color for purpose of coloring or for purpose of polishing, definitely that drug considered to be as a adulterated drug. If any substance mix with it so as to reduce its quality or strength, no doubt whenever we add something to a pure drug, definitely its quality will be on lower side. So such a kind of activity considered to be as an adulterated drug. It found to be in the drug considered to be as an adulterated drug. Now next, that is spurious drug. We already covered misbranded drug, adulterated drug. Now it's spurious drug. Now let's see the definition. If it is imported under a name which belongs to another drug, right? So it's a straightforward one. Name is different, drug is different. So this kind of drug is called as spurious drug. If it is an imitation or a substitute for another drug or resemblance as another drug, right? So this kind of situation or this kind of drug considered to be as a spurious drug. It manners likely to deceive or bears upon it or upon its label or container the name of another drug. So it's again straightforward case. When it is for imitations or substitute for another drug, if such a condition happening in a drug, that drug considered to be as a spurious drug. If it has been substituted wholly or in part by another drug substance, again it's a straightforward one. If it is substituted by another drug wholly or partially, that drug considered to be as a spurious drug. If it claims to be a product of manufacturer or company of whom it is not truly a product, right? It is a false claiming, right? So such a kind of drug also considered to be as a spurious drug. Now last, that is manufacture. Now this is a definition as per the DMC Act regarding manufacture. Now what is manufacture? In relation to any drug or cosmetic, it include any process or a part of process for making, altering, ornamenting, finishing, packing, labeling, breaking up or otherwise treating or adopting any drug or cosmetic with a view to its sale or distribution, right? So this is a kind of process that we are including in manufacture, but does not include the compounding or dispensing of any drug or packing of any drug or cosmetic in ordinary course of retail business. So straightforward, they mention which term should be included in the manufacturing process or which term should not be included in manufacturing process, right? So this is the definition of manufacture. So in this way, we have covered the history of DMC Act. Then we have covered the objectives related with the DMC Act. And lastly, we have covered certain definition that comes under DMC Act. So thank you for watching.